I'll turn the microphones on and we'll just get on with it.
This coming Sunday, it is the 10K. It happens. It has happened for years and years and years. And we'll find out exactly how many years and exactly what it's all about and how you can get involved and how you can support it. I don't know. Can we still sign up for it?
Yeah, you can do.
Oh, actually, let's just introduce yourselves, because I've got my mate Kev, sports for it. Hello, Kev.
Hello,
Webbo. There we go. It'll help if I turn the microphones on. Right, Kev, you're called sports for it because basically you just get involved in everything that's sport.
That's right, yeah. So we crossed paths many moons ago. And,
yes, we did.
And I'm still ferreting around down in Folkestone and in Ashford, and I'll be in Ashford on Sunday. In the middle, I'll be the loneliest man on the day. I'll be stuck in the middle of that big round, the running track,
yep.
With my microphone cheering everybody on after Barry and Jacqi bravely putting on, and we've hit a record high, which Barry will tell you about.
I like that. I like record highs. This is a good start. Barry, we met last year.
Yeah, we did.
Last year, I should imagine.
I guess it probably was, yeah. Yeah, and it's all going really well. I can't believe a year's gone by already, to be honest.
That is mad.
But the bookings are going fantastically well so far. They are still open.
Right, good. That is the main thing. I didn't want to say that earlier on, just in case. But you can still sign up for it.
Yeah, you can still sign. We've got over 1,000 people registered already. Which is,
wow.
We only had about 700-800 people last year, so the fact we've got 1,000 already. But if people go to the website, which is sportingeventsuk.com, there are still spaces available. The limit is 1,200, so we've only got about 200 spaces left. So
okay.
If you're sitting at home thinking, am I going to do it? Am I not going to do it? Now's probably the time to jump in and do that.
The thing is, Barry, I mean, I have to say, I mean, I've been getting myself, I was just talking to Jacqi, and we'll speak to Jacqi in a minute. I've had a year of fitness. I gave up a silly habit. And I've been trying to get myself fit. But I've never, ever thought about running that sort of distance. I've done a bit of treadmill, and I probably do 10, 15 minutes worth of treadmill, and that's kind of me done, and a bit of rowing. If, for instance, would you recommend to say, look, you'll be fine with it, could I just say, I can go and do that 10K? Would you say, I wouldn't, I'd put a bit more training into it? And that's a tough question, I know.
It is a tough one, yeah, because it does depend. I mean, if you're sitting at home and you've normally just got your feet up on the couch, maybe not.
Yeah.
But if you're generally fairly fit, you know, you do a few bits and pieces, then 10K is achievable.
Yeah.
You can always walk a little bit and run as well.
Absolutely. But this is the thing. Now, do you call it a race?
It is for the front people.
You're right.
But a lot of people are doing it because it's their target for the year. It's their first 10K. In fact, there's a hell of a lot of people who've contacted us recently and said, it's the first 10K I've ever done.
Yeah.
Which is fantastic. And with all the support that's out there on the course, I think it's great. But certainly the front people are racing for the win, to, you know, get a trophy, a new best time. And there are a few quite handy people who've registered at the moment that think they're going to do it in about 30 or 31 minutes.
Oh, wow. Right, okay, so it's like the marathon. So basically you're going to let off the professionals. The people that are in it for the race are going to go off early doors, and then the people that are just there for the fun of it are going to move on afterwards.
Yeah, what we try and do is get everyone sort of lined up in a sensible order, so those who are really gunning for it at the front, they'll go off first. Everyone moves off at the same time, but we've got them sort of phased backwards, so based on what sort of time they think they're going to run. So then nobody falls over anyone, everyone enjoys it, but everyone gets to go together as well.
Brilliant. Okay, and you brought my friend Jacqi along. I've known Jacqi for years. Step up to the microphone, Jack. Come on in there. We spoke recently, I can't remember the last time we spoke, actually. Where did I see you?
It was the pyjama walk.
Of course, the pyjama walk, absolutely. Yeah, that was fun, isn't it?
It was.
Are you tempted, because of your being and your athlete, are you tempted to just start running it?
Oh, yeah. We always stay at the front. We always get to the front, me and my friends. It's just a habit, isn't it, inside you, that you've got to
work. No, I listen, I've always known that you've done athletics in one way, shape or form, and you've always been involved in it. And how's brother Brian, by the way? Because he was always very good at school. He was my age at school.
Yeah, he's good, yeah. He's just busy working all the time, as we all are.
Does he not get into his athletics anymore?
No.
He was great at it.
Yeah, I know, but it's time, isn't it?
No, absolutely. So what are you doing up to? What are you up to these days?
Right, so I'm doing a lot of schools in the community, going out to schools and doing athletics, after school clubs and that.
Brilliant.
And obviously I'm organising the fun run for Sunday.
Yeah.
For the children. Do you want me to tell a bit more about that?
Without a shadow of doubt. We've got plenty of time. We don't have to rush for this. I'm going to put a bit of music on in a minute and we'll do it. But no, definitely tell me about the fun run bit.
Okay, so the fun run is for naught years, basically, up to the age of 15, because at 15 you can do the 10K if you want to.
Right.
There's two races. 400 metres is the first race for the ages up to the 11. And then from 11 onwards, they're doing 800 metres, which is two laps around the track.
Yep.
Every person who finishes gets a medal, really nice medal. And there are trophies for the first three girls and the first three boys in each age group as well.
Brilliant.
And hopefully publicity in the paper for them as well.
That's fantastic. So, you were a bit of a... And I don't want to say this because I don't want people coming out and then leaving their kids with you. But kind of, I suppose that some of the parents will be going off and doing the run and the kids will be staying behind and doing the run with you.
Yeah, we've allocated for that. What we're going to do is... when the race goes off, we've got a load of sports hall stuff down on the track and lots of activities going on to keep them busy. Just a lot of fun things, jumping, throwing. And then the fun run actually starts at the end of the 10K, about 11:30. So, and it's only on the day that you can register as well. So if you wake up and you want to bring little Johnny along, bring him along,
fantastic.
Register.
Fantastic. And by the way, he doesn't have to be called Johnny. I'll just point that out. And I just, we need to be specific with my listeners. They go a bit like that. So we haven't got anyone called Johnny.
And I was just saying, looking at you and how fit you look, I think you should have a go at it. Oh,
so. Don't throw the gauntlet down, honestly. I like to rise to a challenge, Jack. I don't know. I've been so tempted, I have to say. Even when I was driving around the other day, because I went up to the Julie Rose to do the lake walk, and I saw it there, and I'm thinking, oh, I wonder. Because it goes right past my house as well. Can I just join there? Because it's not so...
You can maybe stop off for a cup of tea on the way round.
or my asthma pump or something along that. So listen, I'm so tempted, but we'll see. I'm going to put a record on because I'm getting myself a bit tongue-tied now because the temptation is definitely there. Listen, if you fancy that, we'll give you some addresses and some websites and some bits and pieces. Get yourself a pen and get yourself a paper. I'm going to get my birthday bongos out in a minute. But before that, this is Ollie Murs and Kiss Me. The time is now 8:33. I've probably told you that already anyway. I want to love you. Give you that loving, baby. Take you to hide you. Do what you like, baby. I've got to find out how you can be my lady. I've got to do things to drive you crazy. We got one chance and I want it badly. Do you feel like it's going the right way? Do you know what you're doing inside me? If you want that, then bring that vibe, babe. Yeah, you got me, I'm dreaming about it. If you like that, then we can go around it. If you need that, then tell me right now, baby. 'Cause I wanna know, this is the last night. Good one. And don't forget, it's not just a birthday, it's a birthday week. Plenty of celebrations to take into the weekend. Have the most incredible day. And thanks, Bars, for getting in touch. So, we are talking about the Julie Rose 10K. It's the anniversary, or an anniversary.
30 years.
Yeah. Right, you were talking about the first one. Jacqi, I can only assume that you were involved.
I was involved, I ran it, yes. Me and Jenny, who's another Ashford AC athlete, We done it dressed up as bumblebees.
As bumblebees?
I have no idea why. I think it must have been, now looking back, it was the colours of Ashford AC, which was red, yellow and black.
Come on to this microphone, because we're getting a bit of feedback.
Bumblebees.
Bumblebees. You're all right on that one. It's just that we need to separate them better. You're all right. They're good.
And
that's
that
better.
Was from the Stewart Centre.
From the Stewart... Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, they went from the Stewart Centre then. I was also involved in the Julie Rose Memorial Fund when Julie Rose died.
So yeah.
Obviously, we built up a memorial fund and got a load of money in, and then that's when the council took over and started building up for the Julie Rose Stadium.
Right.
So that's going back, as you say, over 30-odd years now.
30 years. I mean, I remember Martin Rose, Julie's brother. I mean, he's my sponsor for the show. Very, very much behind this. And the absolute tragedy. But what's come out of it, I suppose you've got to look on the bright side of everything. You know, and the fact that this is the most incredible stadium. And it is really the jewel in the crown.
Yeah, it's classed as one of the most picturesque stadiums as well in South East England because of the outlook on the Downs. So it's got quite a good reputation.
And it's being utilised. I mean, that's the thing, because I know there was always trouble. We're not making money, and for this football team have gone down there now, which I think is great as well, to sort of help keep it ticking over. But of course, I came down here, well, it must have been 7-8 years ago, when they were thinking about closing it.
Yeah.
And the protests.
Yeah.
I mean, to think that we could have lost it, I mean, it's just crazy.
Yeah, and all the main fixtures in Kent for athletics are all there.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, there are other tracks around, but all the main stuff with the county fixtures... all at stake.
And long may that continue.
Yeah, and of course, the biggest 10K in Kent is there as well.
Yes, of course. And this is what we're talking about at this particular moment in time. Now, we mentioned earlier on, rather briefly, that you can still get in touch. And I think we give a number out. Now, this is the bit where I ask people to get a pen and a paper or get their phones open. We need to give out some numbers and some information. So it's not too late.
No, it's not too late. There are obviously not huge numbers of places left.
No.
About 200 places left at
the
moment. But if they go to the website, sportingeventsuk.com, they can register online there. There's no postal entries or anything like that. Just go straight onto that website. So sportingeventsuk.com. You just follow the links through from there. And nice and easy, just register and away you go.
Is there a fee?
Yeah, there is. Yeah, it's for the if people are a member of a club and they're affiliated to England Athletics, it's £16, and if you're unaffiliated, it's £18.
Okay.
So not too bad. If you want to register on the day, there might be some places, but with only 200 left, it might be limited on the day. But you can register, of course. Do come down if you think you want to do it and you haven't made your mind up. Up until 9:15 on the day, we'll have entries, but it is subject to space.
Yeah, of course, absolutely. However, on the fun run, you can come down on the morning.
Yeah, you can enter on the day. The only thing I say is that you need to try and get there before 10, because that's when the road's shut.
Right.
But as I say, there's a lot going on in the stadium, so when the race is out for about an hour and a half, then children are going to be busy all the time anyway.
Gotcha.
So... just on another factor, obviously, if anyone wants to come and help on the day, we need a lot of marshals to get out on the road. That's one of our main issues as well, because it's a race that's run all around the roads. We need more marshals than many other road events. So if anyone wants willing to come forward and help, that's fine with us.
And we're asking, as always, and they do turn out in their droves, don't they, the people of Ashford, to support the runners as they go past as well.
They do, yeah.
Can you give us a rough route of it?
Well, yeah, it's a difficult one to describe, but yeah.
Most of our people know this very, very well. So we're starting at the Julie Rose Stadium, so let's go from there.
You start on the track in the Julie Rose Stadium.
Okay.
So yeah, nice, just a short section of track to start with.
Yep.
Out of the Julie Rose and turning right, going up the Canterbury Road. You then turn left into the street, going up some of the nice old roads then and across to the Faversham Road.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. Drop back down there to the good old traffic lights that everyone in Ashford knows ever so well and sat there.
Penley Point.
Times. Penley Point. That's it. They turn right there, going past the Bybrook Barn Garden Centre and the Holiday Inn, across the motorway to where Simon Wheel Avenue is.
Yep.
Which a lot of people will be pleased to know that will be closed.
Yep.
Then up to the main part of the town, past the cemetery. Turning left past what is now called the Panorama Building.
Yes, it is.
So going down the, turning left there, going right all the way down the Hythe Road as far as Silver Hill Road.
Yep.
Where they drop down, go back under the motorway, up to the Kennington Road, back onto the Willsborough Road, back into the stadium, and then they get to do the Olympic moment where they rejoin the track, doing 300 metres round the track, right down the side of the grandstand there, with lots of people cheering them on, right to the finish line there. So a fantastic finishing point. a lot of people, even if they're tired at that point, reach that final bit on the track and think, go on, I'll have a bit of a sprint.
Yeah, of course, absolutely. Yeah, you want to put that moment on, don't you? And that dip at the line, even if you're not actually racing against someone.
It's got to be done, hasn't it?
Yeah, without a doubt. Yeah. And then a few little Usain Bolt celebrations on the back of it as well.
Maybe a few Mobots as well.
Yeah, then we've got that.
And in fact, if anyone can do both of them at the same time, you know.
Now, that would be interesting.
That would be interesting.
Have you tried that?
No, I haven't tried it, but I'm sure a few people will try that.
Make sure you warm up first before you do that. You could pull a muscle trying to do both of them at the same time. All right, listen, we're going to have a short little break and we'll tell you more about the Givaudin 10K. We'll also be talking about road closures because it will affect parts of the town as well, obviously. Right, OK. Coming up, I've got music from Craig David and Sting.
Sponsors of Wake Up with Webbo. For beds and mattresses, everyone shops at Home Plus. Call Ashford 633-928.
Radio Ashford. Radio Ashford.
Events Diary.
The South Willsborough and Newtown WI are holding a quiz night on Saturday the 15th of October. It'll be held at the Swan Centre in Turner Close from 7:30pm. Coffee, tea and homemade cake will be available, or you can bring your own refreshments. During the evening, a raffle will also be held. Tickets cost £3 per person, with teams of between 4 and 6 people encouraged. For more information or to book your table, call 620 838. That's 01233 620 838. For your table at the South Willsborough and Newtown WI Quiz Night on Saturday, the 15th of October.
Your guide to what's happening across Ashford.
Community radio across the Ashford borough. This is Radio Ashford.
It was just after 4 a.m.
He was working on the motorway, stacking cones on the back of a truck.
A lorry driver had fallen asleep.
He didn't see the flashing lights.
And he hit the truck at 60 miles an hour.
David was thrown 20 metres down the road.
He didn't get up.
He didn't come home.
He was my brother.
My nephew.
My son.
My husband.
My daddy.
Please, take extra care and help to keep our road workers safe.
Suited and Booted, your weekly dose of soul, mod and ska tunes. Here every Thursday, 9 till 11. Keep it suited and booted.
Want to be part of a brand new stylish 24/7 fitness suite and gym in the Town Centre Panorama building? Anytime Fitness gives you top of the range equipment and state-of-the-art Wellbeats interactive studio. Anytime Fitness offers the ultimate place to work out with private changing rooms and free unlimited parking 24/7. There's nowhere more stylish in town to work out, including new class timetable with a Friends with Benefits scheme, so no need to work out alone. Anytime Fitness offers superior fitness suites across the UK and worldwide.
Going to be built, I assume, or was it because of the tragedy that happened with Julie?
I think it was because of the tragedy.
Yeah.
Originally, we used to train at the North School, and you know what the grass is like there. It goes up and down, up and down. Someone's just standing me still because I always rock when I talk.
I do the same. I do the same. I am.
So, so I think that was the start of it. And obviously then the Ashford Borough Council come on board. So it was there for the making, but that was, you know, the root of it all.
Yeah.
The tragedy of Julie.
So. Well, the tragedy of Julie. I mean, you knew Julie, obviously, very well.
Very well, yeah.
And trained with Julie.
Yeah.
Now, she got to a very, very good level and there was so much hope for the future.
Yeah, and the reason that she was out in America at the university was because there was not a lot of facilities in England at that time.
Yeah.
So she got a scholarship to go out there. So that's the reason why she was out there. And then, obviously, the tragedy happened.
What was Julie's distance?
It was 800, 1500.
Yeah.
English schools champion for years and years. Country champion.
Yeah.
Yeah, such a great bit of talent.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, absolutely. But what a legacy that she's left behind is incredible.
Oh, yeah. And I'm sure her mum, Don and Joyce Rose, are, you know, very, very, very proud of her.
Without a shadow of a doubt. And I know Martin, her brother as well, is top man who helps sponsors our show. So they're getting involved on Sunday, I believe.
Yeah, we've asked them whether they'd like to start the 10K off, and they've agreed to do so. So that'll be a lovely sort of add-on for the 30th
celebrations. That's a glorious thing to do.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it.
30 years. He's still got to comprehend that's 30 years.
No, do you think I've done the first one? No, that doesn't comprehend either.
Yeah, and we have got video evidence that.
Oh, really?
The first one. Yeah.
Seriously?
We've got a DVD which we're hoping to have on at the stadium during the day as well.
Oh, how
so
wonderful!
Can pop up to the little cafe there and have a look and see some of it, and might see Jacqi dressed as a bumblebee running in the 10K.
And Steve Cram started the race that day.
Oh, did he really?
So, yeah, we had a few celebrities on board. So
wonderful.
Yeah.
Yeah, he didn't win though.
No. So I believe that you're taking part.
Well, no, I'm not running in it.
You're not?
No, I'm not running in it. No. Well, being the
you did last year, didn't you?
No, it's. I think I said last year I have run round it.
Right.
But as the race director, there's too much going on in the day to be able to go round. The only chance I'd get is if I could get round it in 20 minutes, I think. But, you know, I'd have to do that on a moped or something.
Fair play, though. Right, listen, we need to give out some addresses, some telephone numbers, some websites. If people want to know about road closures as well, it affects me, but, you know, it doesn't bother me. Was it about an hour and a half? It is about that, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, people of Ashford are always really, really good to us. And, you know, they know that the importance of the race and everything. But it does mean that I think it works out about 70 roads that we close. Obviously, because we close roads that feed into what would be the route as well. Because obviously people can't drive out of those roads into it. Rather than it would be probably extremely boring to read out all 70 road closures. Be like a public service announcement, wouldn't it? But if they go onto our website, again, it's the sportingeventsuk.com. So sportingeventsuk.com. Go to the Ashford 10K page, the Givaudin Ashford 10K page. And down the bottom, they'll find a link to all the road closures. And we've got every single road listed there for people so they can see. The roads start closing just before 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
Because obviously the race actually starts at 10 and they're off round there. Then what we do is we try and do it on a rolling basis. So we try and close off a few of the roads a little bit after 10.
Yeah.
But obviously it depends how quick people are going.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
And what we do is we reopen it in sections afterwards as well. So once we know that the back end of the event is clear of a certain section, we'll open that up again. And we do really, really appreciate the support of everyone around the area with, you know, helping us out and bearing with us during, you know, an hour and a half or so on a Sunday morning.
Yep.
And hopefully lots of people, because they can't go out in their cars, will come out onto the course.
Oh, absolutely. Well, it happens to me. I'm in just off High Road there, so I can't, but that's why I come and stand at the end of it by the garage and clap everyone past. And it is a really good atmosphere. It's a carnival atmosphere.
Yeah, exactly. And one of the things that worked fantastically well is a lot of your listeners, Webbo, came out last year.
Good
stuff. And they did remark how many more people were out there last year compared to previous years.
Yeah.
So with it being the 30th anniversary, we'd love it if as many people as possible in the town of Ashford, or if they're along supporting friends, family, wherever they come from, just come along, get yourself onto the route. The route map is on the website as well. So if you're not sure where it goes and perhaps you're new to Ashford or you're coming into Ashford to watch it, the route map is on there as well. There's loads of great points to watch it. So do come out. It does make a difference.
Oh, well, I can imagine, yeah. People cheering you on, yeah.
That's it, exactly. And when you're running round and, you know, perhaps you're getting halfway round and you think, oh, blimey, it's a bit hard work, this, and there's, you know, a nice group of people there cheering you on.
Yeah.
It really makes a difference.
Yeah.
And we probably should, if we're allowed. Are we allowed to just mention a couple of sponsors?
Absolutely.
Obviously, Givaudin, who are just across the road.
Can you say
it
properly, please, Barry? Givaudin.
Givaudin.
Thanks, thank you. It's Swiss, you see.
Okay, is that what it is?
I just like saying it like that, that's all.
Yeah, that's it. It works, doesn't it? Yeah. Obviously, you know, they're the headline sponsor of the race and have been for a number of years, so we're very, very grateful to them. Hope Spinal Wellness are offering free massages before and after the race.
Oh, blimey, that's going to be handy, yeah.
Yeah, and they're great. There's absolutely no charge for it, and they do that to support the race for us. Pod Plus, they're obviously based at the stadium. They're doing the bag drop for us, and they've also got some special offer items on the day as well, so they're right behind it. And actually Nike from the outlet centre, they're doing the water station for
Brilliant.
Us this year. And the Baptist Church on the Hythe Road are doing a second water station for us. So you're not going to be thirsty by the end.
No. Listen, that is absolutely glorious. Kevin, you've been listening to this. Is anything we've missed out on? Have we missed anything out? Come on now.
I don't think so. I think it's just, you know, a lot of people will be coming along for all the reasons that you've said. I did the 30th, the first one 30 years ago when I was really into my running. It's going to be a great occasion, you know, to get the Rose family back. Just as you said, it's all been said, Webbo, they left a great legacy for the town, to keep running going. The junior section of all the running clubs in the area now use the track, and it's good to see the next generation of runners coming through, which is all about. I'm really looking forward to it. I should be, as I said, the man in the middle, cheering everybody on. I shan't move from my spot. I shan't be running 10K. I shall be rooted to the ground, watching everybody cross the line, and make sure that they go home with fantastic memories of the 30th anniversary race.
Well said, Kev. He's good at that, isn't he?
And of course, we should say, there is a special medal this year. 30th anniversary medal, specially made for it. So it's a real cracker this year. So
well, see, that's what an incredible memento to have. Right, so there you go. It's not too late, but there are limited numbers. This is what you need to know. If you're thinking about it or you know someone that might want to do it, then get in touch with them. Go onto that website. If we can put a link up on my Facebook page, if you can do that, I'm sure, Kev, you can sort that out. Just in case you've missed any of that, Kev will put a link up on my Facebook page. Go to there, and that will take you to where you need to go to if you want to register, and all the road closures, etc., etc., etc. I think we're all right. Have we done that okay, Jack? Anything we've missed out on?
No, I'd just like to say thank you to all the marshals that are going to turn out on Sunday, because obviously it's a big thing for them as well.
Yeah.
And the race wouldn't go ahead if we didn't have these marshals. So, again, if anyone wants to marshal, please go onto the website.
You are still looking for more?
Yeah, I'm still looking for more. Always looking for more marshals, safety reasons. So, yeah, go onto the website and ask about it there.
That's a nice way of being involved as well, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Maybe next year they might want to run it.
There you go.
It's like having a grandstand seat.
Yeah.
But there you have it. If there's marshals, there's spaces left if you want to run, and there's spaces if you want to go and marshal and be part of this wonderful celebration. 30 years of the Julie Rose Stadium and the Givaudin 10K. Thank you so much for popping in and seeing me.
Yeah, thanks for that, Webbo.
Thanks, Webbo.
Absolute pleasure. Thank you, Kev. Thank you, Jack. Thank you, Barry. Right, well, it's obvious. I mean, it's the only record I could play, isn't it? Spencer Davis Group and Keep On Running. This will take us up to the news, and I'll see you on the back of that with our little game.
Keep on running.